The poorly animated baseball scenes are starting to outnumber the well-animated ones, the jokes are becoming too cliché, and the plot is getting a little bit too predictable. All of which to say is I'm very close to eating crow, because this show might be bad. But I'm not there yet. As bad as this episode was, I'm still getting a little bit of residual enjoyment out of Cinderella 9. But, oh man, was this episode bad. It starts out with our girls finally scheduling their first game against another girls' team. The catcher, whose name I forget, decides to dole out the positions to all the players, and these don't feel final because she has Shinonome pitching, simply because she's the most experienced of all the players. But it feels more natural to have her at third base and to have the blonde first baseman become the stalwart left-handed pitcher. So if that does happen, point to my predictability sensors, but again, this is something that I'm expecting to happen anyway. After all the positions are announced, the episode gets away with its one clever animation trick where it shows all of the girls at their respective positions, and then it split screens horizontally. The bottom screen is of their eyes, and the top screen is of their view from the position on the field that they take. This isn't something that I've seen before in a baseball anime. This is very cool and unique, but it's also a pretty gratuitous time filler. It takes a full minute for us to see all of the girls and their positions. And if this were the only time filler in the show, that would be okay, but there are a lot more like this, and the rest of them aren't nearly as cool as this one. After we get the girls announcing their positions, we get to see the uniforms that they wear, and these uniforms are bad. First of all, they wear skirts. Why do they wear skirts? I'm sure you know why they wear skirts, but girls playing baseball don't wear skirts. Heck, softball players haven't worn skirts in my lifetime. This makes no sense except for fan service, and I'm kinda not about it, especially since these uniforms are also pretty ugly. These uniforms are white and brown with pink pinstripes and blue trim. There's also no signage on them, there's no name of the school, there's no names on the back of the jerseys, I don't remember seeing numbers either. As pretty as this show is, the design has a lot left to be desired. And the ugly uniforms come into comparison with the team that they're playing, because the team that they're playing, they're wearing shorts with compression shorts underneath, which seems more suitable for baseball instead of skirts. The one cool thing about these uniforms is that there is a little bit of personalization that comes with them. The right fielder Ukita, who's always dressed in a cat jacket, has cat ears that are coming out of her hat. And the fascist vampire cheerleader still gets to wear her fascist vampire cheerleader hat while her uniform was on. These are both kind of cute, and I'm for that. But the rest of it is, it's not great. So in the previous episode, we had one good animated baseball scene and one poorly animated baseball scene. There are two baseball scenes in this episode, and they're both animated pretty poorly, though not as poorly as the poorly animated one from the previous episode. The movement is still jagged, sometimes it looks a bit rushed, and it's pretty clear that a lot is falling apart as this season goes on. And this would all be fine if I still thought that the story was solid and was moving in an interesting direction, but as of right now, it's not. There's a conceit that they try in this episode that tries to be clever, in which Shinonome reaches first base, and she realizes that the first baseman is wearing an outfielder's glove, and the right fielder is wearing a first baseman's mitt. This is when she discovers that the infielders are actually playing in the outfield, and the players that usually play outfield are playing in the infield, in order to give everyone as much practice as possible, and to demonstrate that the opposing team isn't treating our heroes with any sort of respect. And while that's a decent plot point, the conceit that they use to introduce this is kind of nonsensical. I can believe that there are teams that would have their players switch positions, but there's no reason why a right fielder and a first baseman wouldn't just switch gloves. There's no reason for a first baseman's mitt to be used in right field when you can just use the first baseman's mitt at first base. So, I don't know, if this was the show's attempt to be clever, it wasn't really working for me. But this may be because I am a seasoned baseball fan, whereas someone who's not a seasoned baseball fan might find this aspect interesting and clever. But the rest of the plot doesn't really get any better than that. This is the episode where the girls have their reckoning, where they realize that they're not nearly as good as they think they were, and they need to put in a lot of effort if they want to reach the goals that they set out for themselves. And that's all well and good. That happens in Princess Nine, that happens in Taisho Baseball Girls. But in Taisho Baseball Girls, this reckoning happens for an entire arc. There's like 4 to 5 episodes where the girls are practicing and they suck, and they only get better incrementally. I have yet to see whether this is going to manifest in this series as well, but from the looks of this episode where the girls suck, get frustrated with their performance, and then go to the field and face their failures and repent, I also wouldn't be surprised if this were the only episode of failure that we see in the show. And the whole repentance scene isn't that interesting. Like, all of the girls give the reasons why they believe they failed during the game, but the blocking of this scene is super weird. All of the girls are essentially standing shoulder to shoulder in a straight line, and this is like blocking 101 that I learned in theater. You can't have people stand in a straight line because people don't stand in straight lines in real life. It looks terribly uninteresting and almost as if they put this scene together at the last minute, which wouldn't surprise me because a lot of this episode and the show in general feels last minute. So while it may seem that I'm complaining a lot about this show, it's because I genuinely liked this show for the first 4 episodes and I don't want to see it fall into anything less than mediocrity. But I do fear that it eventually will. I'm still holding out hope that it will improve. I'll give it one more episode before declaring objectively, finally, that this show might actually be bad, but it's kind of on thin ice right now, and I might have to pull back the recommendation that I made in the first few episodes.